Hi there, YouTube. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for watching. Today, I want to make a video about illustrations in Watchtower literature. And this time I chose the Young People Ask book, Questions That Work, part one. I want to talk about how all the Watchtower literature is filled with these weird and silly illustrations, because as a Jehovah's Witness, you don't notice it that quite well, but when you read the literature, like after exiting the Jehovah's Witness religion, it appears really strange. I found a couple of illustrations that I have here on my laptop screen. These were actually texts that were next to some silly images, pictures to compare something to something entirely different. And some stuff is definitely out of context. Well, let's begin. Getting over your parents' divorce is like recovering from a broken arm. The process is painful, but you will eventually heal. And this one is on page 33 for the people who want to read along. And I found a similar one on page 223. A breakup is like a painful cut. It hurts, but in time it will heal. And actually, I hate these kind of comparisons that they make. Like, a parent's divorce is like a broken arm. A breakup is like a painful cut. And it isn't even comparable to one another. Because a parent's divorce, yes, I understand that it can be very painful. But I don't really understand why they compare it to a broken arm. Because, I mean, if you break your arm, I really have no idea. I've never broken anything. Knock wood. But supposedly it's very painful. And it takes some time to heal. But after it's healed, maybe there's something left from the pain. Something, maybe some bones haven't healed correctly. But normally it isn't supposed to hurt anymore, right? When you're healthy again, when you're all right again, then it actually doesn't matter that you broke your arm a couple of years ago, for example, because it's not a problem right now, because it's in the past, right? But stuff like divorce, it's not in the past, is it? Because if your parents get divorced, they'll stay divorced, right? So it can be this gnawing pain or guilt or whatever you feel. So it doesn't really go away over time. Maybe you learn to deal with it better. And actually the same with a breakup. And that is a thing I understand. It's like a painful cut, they say. It hurts, but in time it will heal. Yeah, and painful cut can heal in a week. So I don't understand why they compare it to a breakup, because the pain from a breakup is way worse than a cut. And a breakup can hurt like for years. If a cut hurts after years, you should get checked out by your doctor. Or maybe it can be scar tissue that kind of is sensitive, but still, it's not like something that's very hard to live with. And a breakup can be very hard to deal with and to put behind you, speaking from my own experience. And I don't know if you have another experience with that. And that's fine. People deal with that kind of emotional stuff in their own way. The next comparison or illustration I found is, problems between siblings are like pimples. To fix them, you need to treat the underlying cause, not just attack the symptoms. Same book, page 43. What? They compare problems with siblings to pimples. That is like really, it's not like, I don't know, kind of demeaning and kind of in a funny way. But problems with siblings can be very hard, and pimples go away after you've been through puberty normally, but problems with siblings can be really bad and not go away after you've been through puberty. In my own experience, I have a half-sister that's 10 years younger than me, and we really don't have a relationship. because the when she was born, stuff changed at home in a really bad way, actually. For instance, my stepdad, her real dad's autism surfaced, actually, because he couldn't deal with having a baby in the home. She's 18. We still don't have a relationship. When I visit my parents, she still lives at home. We actually don't talk or interact with each other because at the age of 10, I really wasn't interested in a baby in the household. I'm still not interested in babies because I really don't like babies at all. Problems between siblings are not really like pimples because most skin problems can be fixed with some, I don't know, prescription cream or whatever. But problems between siblings, not so much, right? So they kind of downplay the fact that problems between siblings can be quite big. Okay, next one. Moving away from home is like hiking in the wilderness. You need to learn survival skills before you start the journey. It has nothing to do with surviving skills when you go on a hike. That's really strange. I mean, I understand that you have to prepare yourself if you plan on moving out of your parents' home, because some skills are very useful, like how to clean, how to cook. But survival skills? I mean, do they really mean the like rubbing the stick on some stones to make a fire? Those are survival skills, right? Or how to know what plants and fruits are poisonous and whatnot. We don't need that kind of survival skills, right? In the supermarket, you don't have to look for the poisonous stuff. They already sorted that out for you. They make it really dramatic. You have to have the survival skills. No, you don't. I mean, keep on breathing. You'll survive. So we go to page 153. Time is like a spirited horse. You must learn to control it. First of all, who possesses a horse? I don't have a horse. I don't even have a garden where I live. Really, this is... You must learn how to control... What? This is so ridiculous. It doesn't make any sense. A spirited horse. But as if someone could identify with that kind of situation. I mean, this is not in the... Yeah, it's ridiculous. Whatever. Then we have 177. We arrive at a more sensitive subject. It's about sex and stuff. And we have this gem. Engaging in premarital sex is like taking a beautiful painting and using it as a doormat. What? I don't know. Maybe you can use a beautiful painting as a doormat when you're super rich and you don't have to care. But in the Young People Ask book, there is I guess there's this illustration of the Mona Lisa and someone stepping over it. It's like super ridiculous. Using a painting as a doormat. That's also it is super unrelatable situation. Nobody does that. So even if someone would engage in premarital sex and then just feel really guilty or sorry about it, or maybe come to the conclusion that it wasn't really a good idea, no one would think of that situation like, oh, that just really felt like using a painting as a doormat. It doesn't make sense, right? On to the last one from the Young People Ask book, page 191. Love and respect are like the two wheels of a bicycle. Both are essential. What does that mean? This is the worst. I mean, they might as well have said, love and respect are like food and water. Both are essential. Love and respect are like peanut butter and jelly. Both are essential. So they picked just the two wheels of a bicycle. Like, why are both essential? Maybe some people do like riding a unicycle. So, no, not necessarily both are essential. So I'm going to go through more of the Watchtower publications And the reason why I picked this one is because I've studied a Young People's book, although it was the older version, the blue book, the hardcover. I just picked out this this one book because to me as a youth it was kind of relevant, and I really don't know if I read this book when I was still in. I really don't know when it came out. But you can just download a lot of PDFs from the JW.org website. I just found these gems in the Young People Ask book part one. So maybe I'm gonna go through part two. Maybe there are some ridiculous illustrations in there as well. But I had a good laugh looking these ones up. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Maybe you remember some ridiculous illustrations that were given from the platform during the talks. Maybe you want to share those. I really don't remember a lot from that time. It was a long time ago. But yeah, it's very interesting looking looking at the publications with different eyes, like being out of the Jehovah's Witness religion. So yeah, I had a good laugh, and I hope you did too. So have a nice day, and see you next video. Bye bye.